Seguimos en el Mobile World Congress, donde estamos cubriendo el evento y recibiendo a empresas en nuestro stand para poder traerles lo que está sucediendo aquí en el evento y que se sientan un poco partícipes, incluso si no han podido acceder a este evento desde donde quiera que estén en América Latina. Así que tenemos un nuevo invitado que es John Geary.
Geary. No problem.
Apologies for that. De OpenWave, y él nos va a estar comentando un poquito las novedades que trae la compañía. John, welcome to Telesemana once again.
Mucho gusto.
So tell us what OpenWave is actually showing this year here, and where are you putting the emphasis, or your eggs, in which basket?
Yeah, well, so our eggs are in the basket of the data path, okay. To put it simply, and our focus is on bringing intelligence to the data path. Last year we introduced our media optimization product, our first release of that product. This year, after winning a few customers, which we're very pleased about, we've introduced our second edition of that product.
Okay.
With a great deal of enhancement as we start to look at the next generation of video around adaptive streaming, intelligent caching, and just-in-time transcoding. That's all about providing TCO, total cost of ownership benefits. The second part of what we're introducing here is our second edition of our Passport Smart Policy. This is all about generating revenue. So we're introducing this year the ability to zero rate applications, the ability to provide personalized, contextually aware content that's suited to the individual user's habits, be they seeing websites frequently, mm-hmm. giving discounts for that, or sponsorship for that. Or be they the types of tiered pricing where you get enhanced megabits or per day, or per hour, and now per time. And we've added even per group. So the ability to share your pricing plan with others gives great new revenue. And then on the last part, which is new for us this year, last year we announced our partnership with F5 Networks. This year we're announcing an enhancement to that partnership. And now we're adding to our partnership portfolio, Juniper Networks, where we'll be providing media optimization analytics and our Passport Smart Policy as part of their media flow delivery platform.
Okay. Now, one of the things you were kind of right last year, and actually OpenWave is right, it's about video. And it seems that video is the now the really hot
Thank
application.
Thank you. Not too many people say that.
I'm fair, let's say. So basically, video is one of the topics that we said that was going to be very hot this year at Mobile Congress. In terms of the applications, it's going to be hot.
Right.
It seems that mobile video is everything. Actually, we said forget about mobile TV, it's going to be video. And your platform actually addresses one critical issue, which is congestion.
Correct.
So tell us a little bit more on how you guys deal with video so operators don't have to actually have a tremendous amount of backhaul, tremendous amount of capacity, and they can actually optimize the video experience without increasing proportionally the cost every time a user just access, you know, whatever video they want to access.
You bet, Raphael. You're absolutely right. Last year, we were one of the few, if not the only vendors that were talking about the importance of video. Being in Silicon Valley, you see this and feel it. This year, we're all feeling it. Okay. And the exciting part is our next version of the video optimization focuses even more granularly at some of the key problems we found as we've been deploying with customers. Problem number one is, I don't know that I want to compress all video. So I've got to start intelligently figuring out high motion, high action, pixel intensive video. How do I compress that versus the alternative more slow motion, less pixel intensive video? Because the cost benefit is differently. So we've created the capability of doing that, differentiating. We've also created the capability of recognizing that oftentimes video creates congestion, yes, but it creates it in spots rather than across a network.
Okay.
So we've created effective network congestion, which focuses in on those areas, those hot spots, if you will, on the map where video is intensifying and creating congestion. And rather than brute force everybody in a sector, we create an intelligent video solution that provides sufficient access to keep smooth playing video without trying to compress all the video the same or video across an entire region, let's say. And then the third part about our video solution is that we're also adapting, no pun intended, the new formats which are coming out, the Googles, the YouTubes, mm-hmm. things like adaptive streaming, which are going to take a different type of video management. Rather than handling these in the way you handle HTTP, we look at the resource manager, grab the video, and apply a resource limitation against it so it still runs smoothly, mm-hmm. but it doesn't take up the entire bandwidth as it would based on the fact that, for example, adaptive streaming is a greedy protocol. But at the end of the day, we measure ourselves against the quality we deliver, and that's what our customers want to know. They want to know that we save them TCO, we help them manage their scarce resources well, but we don't impact the end user experience. And so we're very proud about our VMQ measurement tool and capability that shows how this video, even after being treated with adroit and capable compressions and optimization technologies, still comes out with a high level of quality for the end user.
Okay, I like the expression greedy protocol. And that's kind of a very good slogan. What protocol is greedy? So let me also ask you about one thing that I think was also an idea that OpenWave brought to the table, perhaps others did, but in my case, I heard first from OpenWave, was the fact to try to bring the content as close to the edge of the network, am I right with that?
Right.
As possible. Are you envisioning, what is the closest you can get the content to, and are you envisioning a point where content is, the edge is going to be the handset, actually, and users are going to be, you know, you've heard probably in the news that Qualcomm and other companies are trying to promote standards that allow connectivity between handsets, creating a mesh network using the handsets itself.
Right.
So is the handset the final frontier for network, the content optimization?
I think it's going to be at the edge of what we call the smart edge, which is typically where the small data centers are in a network operator. Without commenting too much on a handset, remember, handset has, even today, a limited amount of processing that's capable of.
But it's increasing.
And it's increasing. But the ability to manage and run all of your services inside a handset is still a challenge. I think there'll be some of that done, but I think more typically we'll find that it'll be done, and then I use in parens, in the cloud.
Okay.
Either outside a network, if you listen to a systems integrator, or inside a network, if you listen to a typical operator. Irregardless, the amount of data we're talking about is tremendous, and it's growing proportionally every day.
Okay.
So I think the real capability of moving out to the edge is saying, okay.
Because that still holds true.
Right.
Okay.
Is to say, I need to cut down the amount of data I have to pass back and forth on a network, because that's resource intensive.
Yeah.
But I still need to have a minimum level of intelligence, if not an even greater level of intelligence, and I still have to be able to manage those services across networks, across devices, and across even subscriber profiles. As I mentioned to you, we now have a group plan mm-hmm. where you can share your megabits across your family. So all of that still requires some aggregation point that is, in the pyramid scheme, is big enough to handle that cost effectively. Devices, certainly, you know, we've seen the app world, downloadable apps on a device, works very nice.
Yeah.
But to manage all of that on your device, probably some years away.
Okay. Yeah. All right. Well, thank you so much for stopping by. We'll get an update fairly soon, I guess.
You bet.
So thank you for stopping by.
Thank you.